V soup, volume, temperature at point E is T soup, that is equals to volume at point E is Vg divided by temperature at point D is T set. So our equation is V soup by T soup is equals to Vg by T set. And due to that, the equation becomes V soup is equals to Vg multiplied by T soup divided by T set. Now this shows the complete formation of steam on temperature enthalpy diagram, what we have studied now. So it shows that at pressure 1, at pressure P1, A to B and B to C and D and E. So that is the formation of steam. Now we can show that what happens if the pressure on water increases. So if the pressure on water increases to pressure P2, then we get the line like this. It means in this line, the distance between the point B and D reduces. It means enthalpy of evaporation reduces. It means the heat required to convert the 100 degree centigrade water into 100 degree centigrade steam is less compared to the less pressure. If the pressure increased again, the line is like this. Again and again, the distance between point D and point B reduces. So we may have the question that what happened at very high pressure. So at very high pressure, point B and point D coincide and there will be zero heat required to transfer the 100% water into the 100% steam. It means we will require zero latent heat, or we will require zero enthalpy of evaporation. Again, drawing in the diagram, pressure P1 is equals to constant. So this one is the formation of steam. This is the pressure P2, which is higher than P1. And this line is for the pressure P3, which is again higher than the P2. So a line is drawn from all point B and point D, and that line is known as the saturation curve, and the top of the point of the curve, that is known as the critical point. And at critical point, the water is directly converted into the 100% steam without the wet steam, and that temperature is the critical point temperature, that is 374.14 degree centigrade, and the pressure at that point is the critical pressure, which is 220.9 bar. It means if we increase the pressure of water up to the 220.9 bar pressure, the water will be directly converted into the steam, that is the liquid will be directly converted into the gaseous stage, and there will be no wet steam region in between. So that red line shows the saturation curve, and the top point on the line is the critical point. The left hand side line, left hand side part of the line is known as the saturated liquid line. It means if we mark a point on it, it shows that the state of a saturated liquid, that is at point B. And this right hand side line shows the saturated vapor line. So at any steam at on that line indicates it is a saturated vapor, or it is a dry and saturated steam. In between region is known as the wet steam region. So if any point on it, or the steam having the properties in it, it is a wet steam. It is a mixture of water and steam. And the right hand side region of the saturation curve is the superheated steam region. So it has the superheated steam. So as we have studied till now, there are different stages of steam formation. If we consider at point B the enthalpy associated with is HF, then if it is point C, it is HFG, D is HFG, and for E it is the H soup. So from where we have to get all the data? See, we require HF, we require HFG, we require HG, we require VF, that is the specific volume of saturated liquid, we require Vg, that is a specific volume of dry steam. So from where we will all we will get all the data. So for that, the steam table has been prepared by the scientist. So it has the, it is the table containing all the data. In the first column, we see that is the absolute pressure on the steam in bar. Second column represents the saturation temperature, that is the boiling point in degree centigrade. And next three column represents the specific volume. HF is the specific volume of the saturated liquid. HFG is the specific specific enthalpy of evaporation from point B to point D. And HG is the specific enthalpy of the dry and saturated steam, that is the enthalpy associated with the point D. And the unit is kilojoule per kg. And the next two column represents the specific volume, that is VF and VG. VF is the specific volume of saturated liquid, that is at point B. And the VG is the specific volume of the dry and saturated steam at point D. And the unit is the meter cube per kg. The steam table having, to find out the data from the steam table, we require only one value, that is the absolute pressure on the water, that is P. If we know the pressure on water, other value can be taken from the steam table. So these are the two examples of the steam table has been given. So at 10 bar pressure, the saturation temperature is 179.8 degree centigrade. At 10 bar pressure, HF is 762 kilojoule per kg. 2013 is HFG at 10 bar pressure, and HG is 2776 at 10 bar pressure. At 10 bar pressure, VF is 0.0011 meter cube per kg, and at 10 bar pressure, VG is 0.194 meter cube per kg. This kind of steam table is known as the pressure-based steam table. The steam table are also available in the different format. That is, the first column is T-set and other columns are same. So it is a T-set, then after absolute pressure, then after specific enthalpy and the specific volume. That table, steam table, is known as the temperature-based steam table, which represents the data that if the saturation temperature of water is 10 degree centigrade, what will be the pressure on water? That pressure on water will be 0.012 bar. And at that saturation temperature, specific enthalpy will HF will be 42, HFG will be 2477, and HFG will be 2519. Similarly, the two values of VF and VG. So two types of steam tables are available. Most commonly, for our application, we are going to use pressure-based steam table. It means if we know the pressure on water, then we can find out the values of saturation temperature, then HF, HFG and HG, and we can also get the values of VF and VG. Now, again we will see whatever we have studied. So at state B, the condition of steam is saturated water. Temperature is saturation temperature, that is T set. Now we will get the T set from the steam table if we know the pressure. So T set is known to us. Specific enthalpy at state B, HF is equals to Cp of water multiplied by Tb minus Ta. But we don't need to use this equation. HF can be available directly from the steam table at particular pressure. Specific volume VF meter cube per kg. That data is also available from the steam table. So we can get the all the data from steam table from point for point B if we know the pressure on the water. Now state C. So at state C, the steam is known as the wet steam. Temperature is saturation temperature, which is available from the steam table if we know the pressure. Now the next important is the dryness fraction. X is equals to mass of dry steam divided by mass of dry steam plus mass of water. So for the problem solution, generally they give the dryness fraction of steam as a data. And if they have not given the dryness fraction, we have to calculate the dryness fraction, or we have to find out the dryness fraction. This dryness fraction can also be find out using the different experimental methods, using the different calorimeters. So at the last, or in the next session of the formation of steam, we will study the different methods of determining the dryness fraction of steam, and using that method we can calculate the x, the specific enthalpy of wet steam. The equation is h wet is equals to hf plus x into hfg. Now we know that hf can be available from the steam table, hfg is also available from the steam table, and x is given in the data. So we can calculate the h wet, specific volume of wet steam, that is at point C. The equation is V wet is equals to x multiplied by Vg. Now Vg is available from the steam table, x it is given in the problem, so we can get the V wet. Now the properties for the point D. So at point D, the steam is known as the dry steam. Temperature is the saturation temperature that we will get from the steam table. At that point D, x is equals to 1. Now specific enthalpy of dry steam, h dry is equals to hf plus hfg, or that is equals to hg. So we can get hf and hfg both from steam table, and hg also from steam table. So we can get the specific enthalpy of dry steam. Specific volume of dry steam, v dry is equals to vg. Now here we will get vg from the directly from the steam table if we know the pressure. Now the properties at E. At point E, the steam is known as the superheated steam, and temperature of steam is more than saturation temperature. That temperature is denoted by the T sup. Generally, it is given in the problem. If it is not given in the problem, we have to find out the T sup. Specific enthalpy of superheated steam. The equation is hf plus hfg plus Cp of steam multiplied by T sup minus T set. Now we know that hf can be hf and hfg we get from the steam table. Cp of steam is the constant value, that is 2.1 kilojoule per kg Kelvin, and T sup it is given in the problem, and T set we will get from the steam table. Specific volume of superheated steam, equation is V sup is equals to Vg multiplied by T sup divided by T set. In this equation also, Vg can be available from the steam table, T set can be also available from the steam table, T sup is given in the problem, so we can calculate the V sup also. But here you should keep in mind that T sup and T set should be substituted in the Kelvin only. So as we have seen in the different stages of the formation of steam, point B, point C, point D and point E, we can calculate all the properties associated with the point D, point B, point C, point D and point E using the different equations, but the values we have to take from the steam table. And to get the values from the steam table, we require only one value, that is the pressure on water. So using that pressure, we can find out the different values of the saturated liquid, wet steam, dry steam and superheated steam. So in the next session, we will study the, or we will solve the some problems related to the wet steam, dry steam and the superheated steam, and we will find out the specific enthalpy and specific volume related to the dry steam, superheated steam and the wet steam.